heart whether you would keep his commandments or not. He humbled you, allowed you to hunger, and fed you with manna, which you did not know, nor did your fathers know, that he might make you know that man does not live by bread alone, but man lives by every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. Now you said you love the Lord. Praise God, you said you love the Lord. I'm excited about that. Because everybody here, everyone's name is written down in the Lamb's Book of Life.
Oh yeah.
Every single person's name. And everybody said, I love the Lord. God has the right to prove the authenticity of your words. Little did I know, 7 years ago, the Lord would prove the authenticity of my words. God has the right to prove what you say by things that take place in your life. Everybody can be excited about Jesus when it's going well. Now, come on now. Everybody can be excited about the Lord when everything is going well. But tell me, how many of you, and you can all be seated now, how many of you truly praise God in the midst of the fire? How many of you praise God when you just lost your job? How many of you praise God when you just lost your husband or your wife? How many of you praise God when all the money's gone and you can't even find a penny on the street? How many of you praise God when the cupboard is bare? How many of you can praise God when you can't even get out of bed? How many of you still praise God? But you said, I love no matter what. In 1995, I met a guy that was an awesome guy, incredible guy, and his name was David. David and I had a sweet, wonderful courtship. Little did we know, after we had decided to get married, 8 months after we were married, David was diagnosed with terminal cancer. 8 months. We honeymooned in Tahiti, came back. David had a little bit of leg pain. Kept saying, honey, I've got pain in my leg. And I said, you know what, I'm taking you to ER. And he says, oh, it's nothing. I said, no, David, I'm gonna take you over there to ER. He got over there, they ran some tests. They came in and they said, Mr. Belita, it looks like we're gonna have to admit you. And of course, David and I looked at each other and thought, oh, gee whiz, this was just leg pain. And they said, Mr. Belita, it appears that you have cancer. In a second, the world turned upside down. In a second, everything changed. Now, I'm sure you've been there somewhere when everything just
Yes.
Change. Yes. You don't even know. One minute you was here, and then the next minute you were here, and everything just changed. The doctors had said that they were only going to give David about 2 months to live. How do you cope with 2 months? What can you do? In 2 months, 2 months isn't even enough time to tell the man that you love that I love you. It's not enough time, 2 months. And I'm sure for the people here that are married, you know what I'm talking about. When you wake up in the morning and you're in each other's arms, you know what it feels like. 2 months ain't enough time. So the doctors said what they had to say, and the friends and family said what they had to say. But I had one pastor that had something else to say. And I needed to hear something else.
Right, yeah.
And the pastor said, well, Candace, you told me what the doctor said. You told me what family members have said. But you didn't tell me what God said.
That's right, that's right, that's right.
He said, what did he say, Candace? And I'm scratching my head and I'm saying, he didn't say anything. He said, but Candace, stand on that. Yeah. Because God is the final authority over all things in your life. In your life has to go through God's hands before it can get to you.
Yes.
And he is the final authority over everything in your life. The final authority.
My God, come on now.
I walked out of that room, and of course they had brought in the bereavement lady. The bereavement lady is that lady that gets you ready.
Yeah.
And she wanted to talk to me to help me get the house in order. And I looked at the bereavement lady and I said, I'm sorry, but I can't talk to you.
That's right.
I've got to talk to Jesus.
That's right.
Because he is the final authority over David's life. He's the final authority. Bereavement lady, I can't go home and get my household in order. I